La capitale du pays, qui a accueilli la première vague des gens et surtout des enfants, vivants et morts. C'est notre devoir, devoir du monde de l'art, de parler et de communiquer cette situation tragique, qui n'est pas une catastrophe, na dirais-je, mais une situation fatale pour les victimes qui osent traverser la mer Égée, qui devient mare monstrum. Maria Giannakaki se bat contre la tragédie de Jean Sizet en détient à la souffrance humaine la beauté d'un peintre. Je voudrais remercier pour la présence de M. Carlo Lux et ses membres de la culture de la Comité Sensible. Il va parler à moi. Et la casse quand j'étais là. Et aussi M. Poulogrou qui est présent aujourd'hui.
Good evening. I will speak in English. A few words about my work. I would like, first of all, to welcome you to my exhibition here in Brussels, where it was my desire to present my work in Athens and in Brussels too. My attempt to address through my work the tragicness of a painful current reality entails many dangers, like my potential weakness to transform the real event I'm referring to in a self-luminous creation. The human tragedy became the occasion of my present work. My painterly support I found it in two monumental works of the 19th century. One it was the Raft of Lampedusa of Teodoro de Ripoll, and the other one was the Shipwreck of Don Juan of Delacroix. Meanwhile, I went, of course, to Lesbos Island. I visited. I saw people there. I talked to them. I took some photos, and. After, I worked in my studio, trying to combine all these feelings I had. It was real, not so easy. And I tried not to describe, because I'm not a journalist, I'm an artist. So I tried sometimes to see through an artist's language, like a color, like the medium I use. And of course, but the pictures, the images I had, with especially the children with the life jackets, with this fluish red, or children managed to survive from the rough waves. Another image I had, people wrapped in the aluminum blankets, like those one. I imagine them like little sets. So I paint these like icons, and I use the gold leaf and try to transform them in little sets. So my mare monstrum opposed the tragicness of the subject they address by dedicating to human pain the beauty of painting. This. Thank you so much.
My name is Ami Takahashi, and I will speak a little bit of Greek too, because I am half Greek. And first of all, I just want to say I'm very happy to be here. We have a long UNHCR, UN High Commissioner for Refugees in Athens, has a long-standing relationship with Maria, and her work is truly inspiring, and it captures the tragedy we see at sea today. as people make the dangerous trip to Europe in search of safety, in search of protection, and they cross the Mediterranean. And we've seen the images on television, we've seen the pictures in the newspapers, and I think this is a new medium, and it's very special because it really captures something deeper than the photos show us. And it's also a reminder that a lot more still needs to be done by Europe to respond to the global refugee crisis, because this is really a picture also about something that is a contemporary tragedy that is occurring. Although the arrivals in Europe have, in Greece especially, have dropped dramatically since March, the death toll continues to rise. And this year alone, 4,233 people are dead and missing. So even though the crossing might not be large, it is still a treacherous crossing, and many people die in the process. Thus, we continue to urge and encourage for Europe to provide more legal pathways for people to have an alternative to making such a dangerous journey. There are many forms of legal pathways: family reunification, humanitarian visas, resettlement, any of those, just anything to make it a legal way for people who are trying to escape dangers to their life to be able to come to Europe. Europe is also has had a tradition, not just laws about asylum, and this must be maintained and continued. And Greece is in a challenging situation. The islands have seen a lot of difficulties in terms of conditions. There's detention, there's violence in centers, there's frustration of asylum seekers. We need to speed up the asylum procedure. We need to improve the conditions there. That is something UNHCR is working on. The reception conditions on the mainland are improving a bit, but we need to find solutions for those remaining in Greece, because there are still quite a few. There are over 50,000. Support is needed for Greece. Member states need to support Greece by speeding up relocation. So far, only 6,970 people have been relocated from Greece to other EU countries, despite the promises being in the tens of thousands. So UNHCR continues to support Greece with reception and works with the authorities to find solutions. But in closing, I just want to say that what Maria has done is something very special, and I invite you to take a look for yourself closely at Maria's work, which is both from an artistic viewpoint, it's marvelous, but it really captures this spirit and the legacy of forgotten dreams and desperation. And they're a constant reminder of what is happening at our doorsteps and what we must do to ensure change. So please take the time, look at the work, and support her and support the whole cause of refugees in Europe. Asylum is a very important institution. It's all about human rights, which is in the end at the heart of Europe, the values of Europe. So thank you very much.
I would first of all like to congratulate Maria for this beautiful work, and I think the representative of the High Commissioner has been very right in the words that have been chosen to congratulate you. It's very inspiring, it's very touching. Donc je vous félicite. Je félicite aussi Cléopâtre qui est venu. Qui est venu nous voir à la commune de Saint-Gilles avec ce projet. C'est vraiment. Je félicite parce que c'est une galerie ici qui est là depuis quelques années déjà. Saint-Gilles, il y a 11 années déjà, qui contribue au rayonnement culturel de Saint-Gilles. Saint-Gilles qui est une commune très pauvre, mais dont la richesse principale est justement la multiculturalité avec. Plus de 140 nationalités qui composent le paysage multiculturel à Saint-Gilles. où pas seulement la multiculturalité, mais où on essaie de développer l'interculturalité, la rencontre, l'échange entre cultures différentes. Et donc je voudrais aussi féliciter par la voix du membre du Parlement européen du parti qui est actuellement à la responsabilité du gouvernement de la Grèce, déjà dans une situation très difficile ces dernières années, mais qui en plus a pris sur ses épaules l'accueil de tous ces réfugiés qui sont dans une situation vraiment difficile et où l'Europe ne donne pas vraiment l'exemple de l'accueil où la Grèce continue à les prendre. Et donc j'espère que les autorités, vous avez quand même une certaine influence au Parlement européen, de continuer à faire passer aux autres États membres de cette Union qui a quand même été créée pour garantir la paix. Mais si on veut garantir la paix, il faut aussi que l'Europe rayonne la paix et qu'elle prenne aussi ses responsabilités, notamment tous ces réfugiés qui risquent leur vie, et c'est très bien exprimé ici, c'est assez touchant. Mais donc je félicite le gouvernement grec, j'espère que les autres pays vont suivre, prendre les responsabilités. Donc, et surtout, je félicite Marielle. Donc, je vous invite à bien profiter de cette belle exposition.